I'm smooth walking out of class. When I seen the baddest joint with the fattest ass, I said, oh, what's up? Said, baby, what's your name? She said, get out my
face. My name is Mutaba. For y'all that don't know me, I am the marketing manager for Jonathan. I just wanted to hit y'all with some quick numbers. So Coliseum Dreams officially released last Friday on all streaming platforms. Today we hit 50,000 streams. So.
Hey, that's late. That's very late.
Yeah, if I knew that, I didn't know that shit. We hit 50,000 streams. We got almost 100 albums sold on Apple Music alone. And we got him his first gig. He's performing on a yacht May 21st.
Wow. Okay. Great. Respect to everybody being here. Appreciate everybody being here. We're just gonna get this joint started and keep it rolling. Hey, appreciate it. Hey, tap the. Hey, and make sure you tap wood. Make sure you tap wood.
So the first few tracks is the intro, Miss Melanin, and Rain Little. And to explain, like the intro basically is like it's like a double entendre for the fact that it's just me like coming out saying it's the introduction. Like my first song, it was actually the first song I ever really wrote. You know, so I wrote it up actually in Blacksburg, and at the same time, it's actually like a play off words because I'm actually introducing myself to like a girl in the song. And as far as Miss Melanin, it comes from like a place of me and my mother actually having a conversation, and she told me that she felt slightly disrespected about the way that black women were represented, you know what I'm saying, like in media. And I told her, like, you know, like, well, I would make a song for you and make sure that, you know, like, I could represent black women or women of color just in general better in a song. And I know that, I told her, I said, I know my voice may not be heard by a bunch of people, but, you know, like, any little bit helps, you know what I'm saying? So the song is really based off of the appreciation of black women and also actually has words to black men in the song because black women have definitely served as our backbone since, you know, the beginning of time, the beginning of our existence. And then Rain Load is, I mean, it's just an experience. It's an experience for me. Malik, I know you said you want to say
this. Honestly, y'all, Rain Load, just to talk about the recording experience of it, honestly, was one of the quickest songs that we went through. Rain Load was probably recorded and like cut in like an hour, maybe, if that. Because like Ek was just feeling like we were just given the producer, you know, different things. Ek was vibing, like we were all vibing. Like in the studio, it was a great atmosphere. So, you know, Rain Lou was a real easy track to go through, and I hope everybody enjoys it, honestly.
Yeah, with that being said, Zay, if you can hold us down the first three joints.
It's melanin on the skin, hitting like a summer runs. Tell me just what you want.
So the next few tracks is Good Girl.
I like her.
And Joe's interlude. So Good Girl actually came from a place that, like, I know y'all see on TV, like, a lot of women out here, like, doing stuff, like, you know, getting, like, plastic surgery and all that stuff just so they can be like, yo, I'm a bad bitch. And this, that, and the third. You know what I'm saying? So I was trying to come from a standpoint where I was like, I was just coming from a standpoint where, like, I would rather have, like, a good girl. A girl keeps it natural. She does, like, a thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, she's really confident in herself. Uh-huh. That's why Kenny's my favorite rapper. Yeah, definitely. So, I mean, it was just coming from that place for me. I'd rather have a good girl, you know, that's confident in herself as opposed to a girl that walks around and calls herself a bad bitch. If you know what that means.
Exactly.
Because they got a verse on their joint, which is
I
good girl.
Something.
Ek told me to write
it.
This was a song that incorporated a little bit of past experiences, a little bit of we're not gonna go into detail. But as we all know, music has a lot of influence, and nowadays we don't have a lot of music that talks about, you know, doing the right thing. So if you have that perspective of males looking at, you know, I need to find me a good girl, or girls being like, I want to be that good girl for somebody, it can change the culture. So when he came up with this, idea, I was like, yeah, I definitely got to get on it. I'm gonna try to do my thing as much as possible. Because we don't have that positive music to, you know, like we Like, there's some good people out here. Like, it's, and I can look in this room, so there's good people out here. And our music culture don't really represent that. So I definitely appreciate this track, and I thank John for allowing me to get on.
Hey, who needs a refill? Who needs a refill is the real question. Keep it going.
But it's definitely a letter to the Hive, because I mean, Beyonce on that Lemonade joint, right. She had y'all thinking.
People don't make mistakes.
And she had my boy Hov in the corner, but we're gonna play the tracks, but we had to respond to it. Now he don't touch you like I touch you. You were the one I gave my love to. Get out my face, girl. I don't wanna touch you. All up, he don't love you like I love you. No, it now. He don't touch you like I touch you. And now we don't treat you right, and you always fight. Barely keeping on the house lights. Now I used to put on a keep sweat, and you know what happens next.
So that's it. But I appreciate you all coming out and everything. Y'all are more than welcome to stay. We can drink a little more if you all would like. Say about the place's music. So I appreciate you all coming out.
I just need, before we get the vibe going, I need, if anyone just had anything else they want to say, like about the album, to act like anything, encouraging words, anything. Say that shit. No. I'm saying, say that shit right now, because that's what we need to like move forward. So we're pushing forward to the next project, the next like work, all that shit.
Best friend, I just want to tell you I'm very proud of you, and also everyone who worked on the album. You guys did a phenomenal job. It definitely has an old school vibe to it, which I really enjoyed, and I want you guys to continue working hard. Okay, we talk, but you about to blow
the mic. You said I wasn't gonna do it.
Y'all keep working hard.
So,
hey, we got someone here who wants to say something.
John, for real, this is low-key emotional for me because, you know, we used to be in a performing arts camp when we were 11 and 12 years old.
Hey.
And, you know, singing and, you know, vibing and all that stuff, and to see you, you know, chase your dream and make that a reality for you now.
Right?
Like Maya said, way back from those Edgestar days, you know, you were just breaking out of your shell trying to sing and all that other stuff, and you know, going through high school and really knowing that this was your passion. And to see you create this amazing project is ridiculous. And keep doing your thing, dog. You the man, yo.
Appreciate
it. I'm
gonna get too many comments.
Hey,
work hard on this shit. Hey. I ain't seen John work hard on nothing. I saw my man's lock in and stay focused on what he really wanted to achieve. So respect to my man. Respect to my big. Who you wanna be?
Everybody knows I'm like, man, I'm mad goofy. You right here. I'm gonna give him a joke for that. But like, on a serious note, though, I appreciate it.